Welcome back, everybody, to Hellraisers versus Summoner's Rift, game number one. We cut up the YouTube bots, so for those of you guys who are just now tuning in, we already had the draft. We had some questions about servers and everything else, but apparently, right as we cut to a break, to immediately the teams decided they wanted to do battle. So, while we have this going on, we've got Summoner's Rift going to be starting off with an aggro movement here. Into the enemy jungle, not going to be running an aggro try, but just placing down an early ward, and perhaps going for the first blood. Is Iceberg already going to take that right click? Telekinesis into Miracle Chipmunk, they already have the clap going out. It's Iceberg, they're trying to chase him down, but Brax is already low enough, he's going to end up dying, and Miracle Chipmunk is now going to have to throw out the Battle Hunger in order to ensure the kill, but Johnny Walker is going to be right clicked as well, and now Miracle Chipmunk takes some damage on top of all of that. Meanwhile, Demon wasn't even there in that fight. I think that was the main reason that while Summoner's Rift was supposed to be initiating that fight, they ended up giving away first blood and a secondary kill, all because Demon wasn't there to be able to pop the Shadow Fiend real quickly.
Then you have the PL on bot lane, Goretz the same, down on this bot lane Radiant. Just duking it out. Pretty interesting ward there from the Clockwork. Scouts have the rune and movement from the supports.
Uh-huh.
But does that also block the camp?
It does indeed. Yes, it does.
Very nice.
So it's pretty good, obviously limited on vision of seeing support rotations, but Gorek, I mean, he did get the bounty rune, so that's a big start for Hellraisers. You start this game out with a 750 gold lead, thanks to the fact you get two kills, first blood, and both bounty runes. It's a huge lead for Hellraisers in this game number one.
Even with their 500 ping.
Yeah.
We'll see how that plays into things, though, because Chen, not the easiest hero to play when you've got, you know, zero ping, when you're playing on land. Amount of micro you do have to pull out. But a lot of the decision-making from Chen is definitely based on RNG, what creeps you get. So we'll see what he does early on, whether he'll become a martyr and let himself sit at level 2 for a good 5 or 6 minutes, send creeps towards mid. It doesn't look like Shadow Fiend really needs that much help up against the Brewmaster, though. So I think Goddamn's going to be focused on this top lane quite a bit.
Banana Slam Jamma is going to be your Phantom Lancer player for this game. I'm a bit surprised. I thought Brax, while Brax plays middle quite a lot, I know Brax really likes Phantom Lancer. That's why he drafts it quite a lot. And they do get the Clockwork. Jesus. All right. Well, there goes our kind of first blood of the laning phase. Fourth kill of the game, Dread. Trying to fight up against Miracle Chipmunk, who has taken some of that hard camp. But Dread's got to be careful here. If Chipmunk, well, perhaps he's just being baited. Art is trying to get close enough for a couple of those right clicks. Can get a couple more. The slow. Oh, man. It's just barely enough. Really surprised that the right clicks were there, but he was able to get two different overload charges on that axe.
Man, killing spree on the Storm Spirit. 2.5 minutes in, you've got Sol Ring and 2/3 of your way to Treads.
Yeah, I felt like that was a bit of a bait by the Skywrath Mage, which I fell for. Hell, I was just like, oh, Skywrath Mage, you know, that's an axe. That's really scary, but nice pull of the hard camp there. Very well played. That can be a little difficult to get the timing right on. So, Demon, spot on with that one. Gorek's actually going to try and intercept him here now. Demon puts himself in the trees. He's going to hug himself next to the camp. Rubik does come along for the ride as well, and Gorek's going to be forced back here. So, nice play by Demon. Actually, Gorek just says, yeah, I can take both of you on. At least, try and be a part of the experience. Brax was making a rotation over, so it's a good thing that, Gorek, he probably heard the call from the SF that Brax was making his way over, and that's why he turned and ran into the supports rather than downriver. So Axe is level 3, Gorek same level, so both the Halflaners trying to be very aggressive here. Banana slipping in just underneath those cogs with the Phantom Rush. That ability is so incredibly powerful in some of these early engagements.
I wonder if it's even possible for the Clockwork to put the cogs down before the PL is on top of him.
Yeah.
So I was wondering that. That's kind of how they got first blood. The PL was suddenly on top of Clockwork, then they had Telekinesis Magic Missile to lock him down while the PL just wails on him. But Goretz is going to have his work cut out for him, just trying to block this damage.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty rough. If melee on melee, there's not much space to begin with, and then that hero just bum rushes you with 500. Is it it's max movement speed, right? No. What is it? Do you know what it is?
Phantom Rush movement speed? I'm not sure.
I feel like it's max, but it almost feels like it. Maybe it's a little bit warm. Gorek is going to die here again as Banana Doppelganger in. Gorek still not fighting. Oh, God, 3 health. Now he's going to get enough mana to be able to throw out. Oh, man, Banana. Couldn't quite get there for the Lance. And unfortunately, 3 HP is all it takes for Gorek to be able to get out alive.
Oh, it's in the alt text. Rush movement speed is 800.
Yeah.
So definitely more than max.
I was like, it feels like more than max movement speed, but top lane, they're going to go for a gank here on Artis, but it's already been kind of spoiled. Fortunately, Trowf and Demon not finding the opportunity. I mean, the fact that Gorek dropped down to 3 HP and didn't die there obviously shows, like, hey, the supports aren't around. You know, they're going to be ganking, and it seems like Hellraisers are anticipating this gank to come up to the top lane, which they kind of already did get revealed by the Wave of Terror, which it looks like Demon's going to be going for a 1-4-1 build on his Vengeful Spirits this game, which, I mean, you've got a pretty significant amount of physical damage. I guess that works.
It's going to increase the damage of the PL Illusions as well, so it's going to be good.
Are they going to get Gorek here? He is nice and close. I didn't realize Phantom, I mean, it makes sense, but Gorek slowed down. He's just going to run himself away. Cogs would probably be a bad idea there, because if you accidentally suck the Phantom Lancer up inside the Cogs with you, you may actually die from a bit of that pause of being inside the Cogs. So he just stays ahead of the Vengeful Spirits, so never mind.
Doppelganger too good. Banana Slam Jam did get a little bit lucky with the placement there. His main hero ended up between the Clockwork and the Tower, so he managed to get a bit of a block off as well, but Gorek really has his work cut out for them. Brax hastes it up, heading towards mid-iceberg. Gonna take a crit to the face, and probably Split Even thrown out there.
Yep, stun him up. We have the Skywrath Mage here, but it's not gonna protect him against the Brulings. His iceberg is gonna be run down. Trowf tries to go on him, but not good enough, and now Dredd is gonna be stunned up as well as he wanders back into the Brewmaster. They try and chase him down, but the Brewmaster ultimate does fade, and Brax will get himself back to safety. So, good pick off there on Iceberg.
Not seen too much of Chen this game. He's level 4, nearly level 5, 6, or almost 7 minutes into the game. He's got a couple of stacks going, but his lane presence hasn't been felt at all.
In which case, you would normally expect him to be, you know, pretty far ahead in Golden Experience, but he's not that impressively far ahead. But
he's got really unlucky with creep camps.
Yeah, he still hasn't got a Wild Wing Ripper, which is how you're going to clear through this stack.
Just one over to the far west. Storm jumps onto the axe. Can I get him?
Slow him down a little bit more with the extra bit of damage from every single one of these overloads. Seam Miracle will end up dying. And man, Artis was just on the edge there of the tower. I didn't realize that little hole. You can stand there and be out of range of the tower. It must go something like that. It's pretty crazy. But nice little pick off on Miracle Chipmunk, who may be resigned to go full jungle now. Johnny, oh dear, Trowf. He was, I'm betting they were going to have the axe go ahead and jungle, and then Trowf was like, well, I'll just soak up whatever experience I can, but the double long-range initiations there are just too much for him to handle. And no, axe does go back up to this lane. It's a bit surprising. Bottom lane, Gorek, once again surrounded by the Doppelganger Illusions, as well as the Phantom Lancer, and does end up dying.
If you don't play against this hero regularly, it's really hard to tell when and where he's going to hit. Because all of a sudden, he's got 5-6 illusions suddenly surrounding you. You can't cogs, you can't play defensively. Clockwork, again, we saw this in the last series. If he's getting dominated in the lane like this, sure, it's not 0 and 10. But he's died 3 times in the space of about the same amount of minutes. And he can't go back and jungle.
Blink Dagger up soon for Brax. He's trying to rush that one as soon as possible. Which you can understand why. I mean, pretty much all the heroes except for the Storm Spirit are super susceptible to the Brewmaster's Blink Clap. Particularly the supports. Banana Slam Jamma, who found himself a regeneration. A little bit surprised to see the safe lane carry go for a bottle.
Yeah. PL, I guess, is a mana-intensive hero.
He really is.
We used to see, like, you know, like the old Naga build? A lot of the illusion characters would go it when they were going into Radiance, the Tranquil Sol Ring. just so they could spam out their spells. That's what I was kind of expecting from PL, the current iteration of his skill build. I thought he'd be more like an offlaner, go for Sol Ring a bottle, control bot rune, get bounty runes, and just spam out on the support. But if you go bottle safe lane and you get yourself a good early start, I don't see why he can't play it as a solo safe laner.
All right, Banana is going to be caught out by the silence. Looks like it's just going to last barely long enough. Oh, actually, Dread. I was just wondering, did he go for the max silence build? He does. He did. It makes a lot of sense for this game.
He do.
Locking down the Brewmaster and the Phantom Lancer as long as possible is going to be the biggest task of the Skywrath Mage. They did farm through that stack. I'm presuming the SF was able to clear through it.
Do you think Arthas goes for an Orchid here? Like, it seems good against the PL and Brewmaster. Just straight up. Because he's saving up quite a lot of gold, which feels like he's going for Bloodstone as his first item.
I mean, I hope he goes Orchid. Let's be honest here. You can't depend on the Skywrath Mage for his silence all the time. So I would much prefer to see Arthas go for an Orchid, but maybe he's still deciding. And that's why he's holding on to so much gold. It's a little weird to hold on to gold when you could have components all over the place.
Oh.
And Bloodstone it is.
Okay. So by no means is it a bad item.
No.
Like, it gives you so much HP and increases your mana pool by such a massive amount. And it also allows you to farm faster. So going Bloodstone into Orchid allows you to get both items faster than going Orchid into Bloodstone. Of course, it depends how many kills you get with the Orchid Silence and how much you can actually make from that item, but...
Did he actually increase his mana by using Sol Ring and grabbing that mana booster? Because that's what he did. I'm just like thinking about it. I'm like, did he actually? How much did he really increase his mana by using that Sol Ring and then grabbing the mana booster with it? Was it actually that much?
What do you mean?
As in, he popped Sol Ring.
Yeah.
In order to get 150 mana, and then he grabbed the energy booster, and then the Sol Ring debuff went down, and he lost that mana.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, he did that.
But what does that do?
I don't think it does anything.
Because I even saw him tread switch as well.
Yeah.
He switched to Agitreads.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I don't think it does anything, Dyer's but bottom tower is if under it does, attack. Maybe it's just a super, super small efficiency thing.
But it's not like he cast any spells afterwards either.
Yeah. Yeah. No, he just, like... He used it as he was running up to get his energy booster, grabbed it, and it was gone by the time he came back to lane.
Pretty sure there used to be a bug with Sol Ring and Arcane Boots, but I can't remember what it was. Did it would give you permanent mana increase?
But I'm pretty sure Arthas actually jumping on a Miracle Chipmunk, but there was already the response there of the supports. Demon was lying in wait for that one. And now Brax... trying to get close enough to Dread. Chen is here, and he's just going to make sure Brax can't do anything more. Meanwhile, Iceberg just lit loose his ultimate on an illusion. Yeah, that just happened. Meanwhile, Brax is going to jump on the goddamn still. Will be able to get off the ultimate. The Centaur Stomp will help goddamn a little bit, but he's still going to go down here most likely. He pops his ultimate to help him out. He actually nets the Fire Panda. That'll buy him some more time here. They even grab it and are now going to try... Nope, the Cooling Blade dunk there from Miracle Chipmunk. Too much. They throw the Clockwork up in the air. All that work. Two ultimates just to try and save the Chen, and it wasn't even worth it. Now Art is going to make the jump here, but... Oh, never mind. Gets hit by the Magic Missile. The call goes down as well. Unable to stomp that one. And now Hellraisers. Completely dependent. Oh, the nukes dropped by Dread. Still not going to be enough there as the swap goes down from Demon. And Gorak... unable to do anything without his hookshot. So Hellraisers expend a lot there and do nothing with it at all. They still end up losing all the heroes that Summoner's Rift were gunning for. Is under attack.
If the player drops a large mana pool item such as Bloodstone or Scythe of Ice before using the Sol Ring, the player will regain a large percentage of their mana pool. A larger percentage of their mana pool.
Right.
So he was already on full mana pretty much anyway. I guess if... he needed to cast spells straight afterwards, and it is being super efficient. But it's one of those things, like trade switching. He's just being really pedantic. I guess once you're in this mode, you have that muscle memory where you're like, okay, I drop this, I tread switch, I Sol Ring, use Magic Stick all on Agitreads, and then switch back to Int.
Top lane, Gorek. This is no. This is the SS bounty room. And he'll get a hit of the bottle as thanks from Iceberg. Mech is going to be up soon for the Shadow Fiend, so he's going to go for the Mech BKB build. Which I agree with this game. I mean, the potential for Yules could work out here if you were always with a silencing hero. But the problem is, too many of these heroes, you can't blow them up solo as the SF. They're too tanky. And plus, they all have certain abilities to get out. Doppelganger, Brewmaster Ultimate, as well as the Axe Call.
And like Vengeful Spirit, if she's well positioned, just swap them out.
Ah, that's also true.
Or even swap the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Axe has got himself, it's going to be going Blade Mail, but has just a cloak for a little bit of resistance against this early magic damage to the side of Hellraisers. Artis is looking for some pickoffs here. Unfortunately, he's going to be running into Phantom Lancer Illusions.
Tower is under attack.
So unfortunately, his surprise is kind of spoiled now.
Piel is a really efficient jungler. There's always illusions to doppelganger, the fact
that he's got Brax, the nukes! They finally get him.
Haste of Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, Demon. I think he was thinking about going for a swap there on Iceberg, but the Haste Rune, no can do.
But yeah, the fact that PL can build up an illusion army and basically then jump them from camp to camp. He's like Antibase just earlier.
Yeah. This is exactly why Banana's going to go for the Yasha to increase that efficiency. Middle tower is going to fall. Axe jumps in, gets the call. Gorek misses that hook shot. And now, actually, jump in from Artis. Going to be able to grab Trout, but he's got to be careful here. Cog's in a great position. He's going to be able to knock around some of these heroes. The illusions do tank up most of it. Well, finally, the Rubick does fall. Iceberg's taking a lot of damage here as he's out of mana, so the Phantom Blitzer's not really doing that much. Demon is going to be taken out farther back up to the SF. He does manage to live through all of that. The silence on the Banana Slam Jamma back over. Looks like a Call of Miracle is going to be able to get Artis. And now they're going to go for Dread as well. They should be able to get that kill on top of it. Phantom Lancer here. So the SF survives. A lot of heroes do end up going down. Summoner's Rift lose both of their supports. The middle tower does end up falling.
Where was Chen through all of that?
Not there.
Not there? Farming Aghanims? 17-minute naked Aghanims? Fair enough.
What?
Obviously, the Shadow Fiend has mech, but...
I mean, we did see in the beginning, like, how do I play Chen with 500 ping, right? Well, I guess you play him where you get your Aghanims, and then you build these ancient creeps, and then you A-click them on buildings.
Yeah, you keep the ancient granite golem with your Shadow Fiend and Storm, then you get a couple of dragons and thunder lizards, and yeah, A-clicks them down a lane.
Weird. Storm Spirit Bloodstone. Storm Spirit Bloodstone. So he's got that mana regeneration item. He's going to need a lot more. Back over to Networth here. Blade Mail going to be finished up by the Axe. We still have the Phantom Lancer sitting top of the board, but both the SF and the Storm Spirit are not too far behind. Axe, Brewmaster, getting a good amount of farm as well, while Clockwork is lagging behind a little bit, as Clockworks tend to do.
Oh, Brax. Silent Stop, Goretz does not have Hookshot.
Oh, that's unfortunate. No Hookshot, no Cogs. Yeah, he missed the Hookshot at some point. So, Diffusal Blade finished up by our Phantom Lancer. For some reason, I thought he already had that. Guess not. Roshan, Axe. Oh, God, Axe. That's a wrong neighborhood to jump into, my friend. That's many, many heroes popping out of the pit, and now they are ready to... Does the tornado slow your... It doesn't do anything besides movement speed slow. Like, it doesn't do an attack speed slow at all, right?
No.
Just curious. I saw him throw down the tornado on Roshan.
That does a bit of damage.
Yeah, for sure. Banana Slam Jamma. Artis is going to commit to trying to get this kill. He's like, I don't care. I've got Aegis. Just make sure this guy dies. And Artis will even survive. As no till whatsoever from Summoner's Rift. Instead, they're going to try and push up that top lane as fast as possible. But goddamn with his every 30 seconds, and that's the crazy thing about this. It's not only getting ancient creeps, but every 30 seconds you're healing your own creeps back up to full. Where's his ancients, though? He hasn't gotten any yet.
No.
Why hasn't he gotten any yet? Top lane, Orek. Oh boy, he hookshot it in just to try and force the fight now. Oh, the turnaround there from Johnny. Able to get the hookshot and then the Cyclone follow-up. Dread's going to be cleaned up. So far, one for two, but Art is still decently healthy. He's going to be going on to Demon here, trying to slow him down. Iceberg is throwing up that, unfortunately, couldn't get off the mech, and the Chen heal just a little bit too late as well. Unfortunately, I think that was just coming off cooldown, and it was really surprising that Hellraisers tried to take that fight. I thought they were just going to give up the Tier 1 and just continue to push.
Yeah, they sort of went in one by one, giving away kill after kill. Axe coming out with, what, two, three Culling Blades? The Wild Wing Tornado does give him attack speed slow.
Wow.
It does a bunch of stuff. Move speed 15%, attack speed 15.
I didn't know that.
Learn something every day.
So small. Seriously, Goddamn's actually actively killing the biggest creeps in the ancient stack.
Yeah.
Now, I can understand if you're like, I really want Golem, but in the meantime, why don't you get yourself a Black Dragon, friend? That's, what about that?
It's, pretty useful, huh?
Yeah. I mean, you can't only have two. But one of them could be a Black Dragon. Top lane, Artis. Oh, dear. He's out of mana. He's out of mana, and he may be dead. He's got Bloodstone with 11 charges, though, so he actually may get out of this. His Brax is searching for him everywhere. Is there any... Oh, they don't have a Tier 1 tower anymore. So there goes that. Brax immediately pops the Invincible and bounces out. So he's not going to be caught, and there doesn't seem to be any vision whatsoever on the side of Hellraisers, so... Good pickoff there from Brex. The push in, though, from Hellraisers will go on to the Tier 1 tower. Looks like Summoner's Rift want to fight this, though. They've got Miracle Chipmunk, who's going to lead the charge. They also have Brax ready to go with a clap. He doesn't have his ultimate, but Iceberg is still going to get low. Pretty damn low, but not low enough for a Culling Blade. Now his ultimate goes off. Almost able to wipe out two heroes. Gets the Axe. Brewmaster, swap out. Now he's going to be able to get off his ultimate. Now he turns this fight, going for Gorik, is going to be able to slow him down, hits the stun Cyclone onto the SF, while the rest of the team is chased down by the Phantom Lancer. We do have Artis, who's trying to go onto Banana Slam Jamma.
Oh.
And have a bit of a pause here, while, unfortunately, Artis, yeah, he stopped moving for a while there.
But I was just watching Brax's ultimate come off cooldown. 5, 4, oh my god, he's dying. Yeah. 2, he's dying, he's dead. 1, swap!
Yeah, that was perfect. Perfect timing there. Artis is going to come back. I think he's got Banana Slam Jamma. I mean, that is a silence that has only just now started to tick on the Phantom Lancer. So he should be able to zip in, grab him, call him, take out the PL. That point in time, I think you just zip out. I don't think you are able to save your Shadow Fiend, and I don't think you're going to get another kill. I mean, maybe you stick around to try and kill the Brewmaster because you know he's super low when he comes back. But
how long... until Promise Split is down. Duration is 17 seconds, and it's over halfway through.
So you're talking about 8 seconds?
7 or 8 seconds left of that Promise Split.
Right.
Maybe a bit like 6 or 7, probably, looking at that time, actually. I don't know if Storm needs to use Vortex here onto the PL. 445 HP with level 3 Remnant. You could probably get away with zipping, hitting, Remnant, hit, and then zipping once more. You've got 12 Bloodstone charges, so you've got enough. He's just got to worry about these illusions. There's a couple of illusions actually heading over to hit him, so losing mana is definitely something he has to be wary of.
Yeah, I mean, if he's able to zip and kill this Phantom Lancer and kill off the illusions without losing too much of his mana, and I'm talking, like, still keeping, hopefully, like, 40% of your mana, he might be able to just, like, kind of stick around and just wait for the Brewmaster to come back. But otherwise, he's probably going to have... Oh, well, he does have 14 Magic Wand charges, so that's something. The SF, well, I'm surprised that they forced this fight without having the BKB. SF almost had it. I mean, they didn't take the Tier 1 tower, and yet you look at his gold, and he basically has enough for the recipe.
Can Shadow Fiend survive 13 seconds? 800 HP, I'm pretty sure he can, actually. Hand of God is off cooldown in 13 seconds. It's going to be tight, but...
That's going to be very close. Maybe. Maybe Stormshare wrecks this whole entire fight. Like, the SF just survives... Artis goes from killing Banana Slam Jamma, zipping over to kill Trowth. By that point in time, the Brewmaster ultimate is back. You kill him, and then all that's left is Demon.
So 800 HP. Oh, there's Magic Missile as well. Yeah, it's going to be really close. Iceberg's probably just dead.
Probably.
But then you've got the Requiem on
Death. Oh, you can click on the portraits and it shows the exact amount of time. I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah, because they're like illusions.
Yeah.
So 7 seconds.
But I just can't believe Hellraiser's tried to take this fight. I mean, they almost had BKB. Why not finish up BKB? Because you know Summoner's Rift is going to fight you. They've got really great team fight. Unless they thought they were pushing in without the Brewmaster ultimate.
If they'd killed that Brew before he popped Primal Split, though,
yeah,
that would have been fight
over.
The
fight.
They also just lost the Storm Spirit's Aegis to the Mortal, which would have been pretty massive as well, because he could just ball in, find supports on the back line, give his life away, and come back with full HP and full mana, but every step for the past minute or so has played into Summoner's Rift winning this team fight in front of their Tier 1.
Yeah, it really has.
Still waiting to see Chen and what he can do. literally,
look at the SF here. He's like, you see this SF, and he's just trying to run away, and he's getting lightning bolted. There's a big boulder heading his way. Like, everything is going after this SF.
Imagine, what is it, Chariots of Fire, the song?
Oh, yeah.
When he's just running in slow motion. Gotta get away!
What the hell is that? Is that what the attack is from the storm? The storm panda?
What is that, a pot or a panel?
It's a pot with like an axe attached to it.
The hell? Like,
yeah.
Really?
Look at that. It's like. You know what it makes me think of? I think it's one of those like sort of melting pot sort of deals, but for when you're crafting, when you're dealing with hot metal.
Smelting, yeah.
Yeah, a smelting pot. Thank you. I think that's what it is.
But I'm so sure when I've seen the Storm Panda fire projectile, it's like a little white...
Yeah.
...thing.
That's what I thought.
Because he puts his hands together and then he goes... Psh! And the white ball of lightning or energy, whatever it is, shoots out of him.
So maybe this is what the electricity, the white stuff
is. Are you sure
around.
That's not the cat? That's the catapult dying, dude, actually.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well.
I just realized that there's a dire catapult that's crumbling on the floor. What are you talking about? You're so dumb.
Listen, look at it. It looks like a projectile floating through the air. All right. What goddamn part of the catapult is that? I'm going to go find another catapult. Catapult?
Dire catapult. Hello? Is there one anywhere on the map, please?
Is there really not one left? Oh, my God. We have too many siege creeps.
The extinction of the dire catapult.
What siege the creep. Hell? How does the siege creep die already? Like, isn't this the wave with the siege creep? Or maybe it was the one before that.
Magic happened.
Must have been the one before that. All right, let's go. Let's see if the SF survives. Let's see if Artis is able to do good work here. So the startup artist is going to jump on a Mana Slam, a Jamma, and will be able to finish him off just barely before the Cyclone. Our SF does end up dying. Now, the next up, Brax. Storm Spirit. Brax, make a bleep away, buddy.
He can blink.
Oh, no. God, he does a blink! Now the charges goes off. Artist might be able to kill him if he just gets some right clicks, and he's missing everything. Oh, my God. Artist literally does not hit. And now he's going to have to go uphill. A little bit of a Hand of God action will keep him alive, but...
What?
Oh my God, that was absurd.
Four in a row?
55% miss percentage chance plus a 25% dodge chance means Brax is immortal.
55 plus 25 equals 100, yeah.
Yeah, that's. I think that's math. I think that's math right there. Wow.
Yo, Chen. His ult's already back off cooldown.
All right, so Chen, Ancient Creeps, please. Oh, he's got it. He's been waiting for this all his life.
Okay. I was wondering what the hell he was doing with his creeps and maybe just send them into the middle of Axe, but he heals them up, brings them back to himself. Does he take it?
Thank you. He took it. Finally, the 15% increase to HP, so. Where's goddamn going? Oh, he's going back for boots. He's got Vlads as well. Jesus, this guy wants to be a one-man army. This guy literally wants to just try and, like, get the biggest ancients he possibly can, the fastest, and just A-click it.
is under attack.
23 minutes in, though. Like, usually we're seeing Chen's with Arcane's mech at 23 minutes. This guy has... What's his net worth? 7,300?
Doesn't even seem like that much, but because he forwent any other items. You know?
Yeah. Went straight for the big one.
Yeah.
Then there's poor old Goretz. 4,000 net worth. Tranquil Boots trying to make blade mail. But he's kind of a throwaway hero.
So, the three-man push-in Hellraisers are looking for someone, anyone, to pick off. That way they can push into the Tier 2 tower nice and early with Goddamn. He's going to be leading the charge. Iceberg trying to finish up his... Well, he does have his BKB. And still has another 1,500 gold on top of that.
Suddenly gold.
Yeah. SF, what a hero.
He was sitting on, what, 1,300 at that team fight, and then he died? Did he manage to finish his BKB before he died? I didn't check
that. Maybe he did. Maybe he already had the recipe hiding somewhere and I didn't see it. What was that? Axe, please. Calm down. Call. Down.
Not even going to dignify that with a chuckle.
Oh, that was great. Boots of Travel picked up by Phantom Lancer. Interesting pickup for sure. And TP out from the Chen.
Split push PL. Play him.
Yeah.
Play him like an AM or a Spectre, I guess. Push him up on one lane, take down tier twos, and then TP back into
the
fight.
I mean, it's very clear that Hellraisers are trying to bully you out of this game as soon as possible, right? Which is five manning a click in, so. The call on Miracle Chipmunk. Meanwhile, Clockwork does manage to catch the Brewmaster. Oh, that's a big play. But meanwhile, we do have the Zip still on to Miracle. Zip back and forth. Artis managed to dodge the Magic Missile there. Swap will stop the ultimate. And now the call as well. Iceberg is going to be right-click down. He loses his life with his Phantom Lancer. And all the extra damage is too much. So even though they got the Brewmaster there before the fight even started, they didn't have Gorek. And the result is a Brewmaster for the SF. Looks like they still want to push in, though. While Summoner's Rift are still a little bit low.
Yeah, it looked like mid lane they caught him out with the good old hook shot into Cogs and Mystic Flare combo.
Yeah.
Just slants him up and nuke him down. But how many ultis are available from the Radiant right now? Radiant. All of them? Except Swap, attack. Which is off cooldown in 10 seconds. They're going to smoke up here 15 seconds until Brax returns.
Oh god, they could get a triple call, just the double. Miracle Chipmunk still can potentially pop. Goddamn, nope, there goes the ultimate. He'll still die, but at least he gets off his heal. And then, just here comes the Phantom Lancer, overwhelming the rest of the team. Correct, guys. Artis, as well as Dread, will both be able to get out. But again, it feels like Hellraiser's just like trying to push this a bit too early all the time.
Top tower has fallen.
You know, like they force that fight bottom while they get the pick off in middle, you know?
Yeah.
That doesn't make much sense. Brax, he's just like, whatever, dude. You can only hit me 1% of the time, so. I don't really care about no goddamn SF.
Yeah, HR, they get the pickoff on Brew with basically two support heroes to clock in the Skyrath while their two cores try to go for the tier two. That's a bit that I don't really understand, is trying to press it that early.
Yeah.
I can understand them continuing to fight after the fact, though. They don't expect the smoke and reinitiation from someone as Rift because
sure, yeah.
Brewmaster's down. They know there's going to be no Primal Split. So they feel like they're stronger there with their BKB on Shadow Fiend, Mech, and Hand of God. They've got everything at their disposal. But it was a good play from Summoner's Rift just to take the fight to them.
Bottom Tier 1 tower is, or Tier 2 tower is in deny range. But nobody from Summoner's Rift has picked up on that yet. Jump. Chipmunk does get onto Iceberg here. There's going to be a swap as well. BKB activating. He's going to pop his ultimate here. Surrounded by heroes.
Oh.
The Phantom Lancer dodges it with the Doppelgang. Beautiful play there. The Cogs going to bounce some of these heroes back. And the Cyclone still holding Gorek up in the air. But now he's back down trying to go in. But the Phantom Lancer is going to be able to surround some of these heroes. Cyclone once again on the Storm Sphere. Gorek kept alive here thanks to some of these heals. Same goes with Iceberg. They're burning through a lot of this mana. It's banana though. Another doppelganger.
No.
Oh no! He couldn't get up the cliff! And now it's fairly obvious which one is the real one. Takes him out. Three heroes die on the side of Summoner's Rift, and nobody from Hellraisers, just thanks to the sustain of Mech and Chen Heal.
And that was even with Primal Split. Mainly because of the swap from Demon there. I've got to say, that wasn't the play. He swapped the Shadow Fiend back into a great position to create a Requiem off.
Uh-huh.
Sure enough, Phantom Lancer dodged that with Doppelganger. but Venge got nuked into oblivion. Axe was then in a position where he was cut off and between SF and the rest of HR, so they focused him down. So that was two heroes down without really any expenditure from Hellraisers.
Goddamn still does not have another creep, and I guess he just wants all the auras. He's keeping the Wildkin for the extra three armor. He's keeping the Centaur for
no aura
stunning.
Centaur, no.
Yeah, no aura from him anymore. Johnny. Trial just zips in, makes a little cheeky play. This tier one or tier three tower is being kept alive, primarily because the miss percentage chance on the SF. This is really obnoxious.
It's still supposed to be.
Oh yeah, they sent it back. I didn't see the animation. I heard the sound. I was just like, but I don't see the animation.
It still disappoints me that the Hellbear has that attack speed aura now and not the Centaur.
Yeah.
Why? Why did you give it to him?
Radiant's bottom tower. I like it. Attack. Centaur was too strong. Too strong. Four staff soon for Radiant's Dread. He desperately needs that. Desperately. He's actually going to try this. Artis? He's on the left side. Artis is going to try and grab him here. Reveals him for a second. Still going to be able to grab him now. Dread with the silence and throw down. Never mind.
That magic damage.
You do not need an ultimate at all, apparently, as there was just too many nukes. Demon's going to try and catch one of these heroes, it looks like. The rest of his team is coming in, but they're a bit far behind for him to just swap and initiate. And now, oh dear, Clockwork sees that one, but he knows he's not alone. There's no way the Vengeful Spirit goes out like that all by himself after they just got a kill on the Phantom Lancer.
PL doesn't get any increased magic resistance anymore, does he?
No.
His ultimate used to give him like 5, 7, 9% or something extra.
Yeah,
Johnny
something
Walker.
Very small and weird. Swap.
Still going for this?
I guess so. Support is in the way, but Gorak is still going to be taken out fast enough. And, yeah, he just overextends himself, it looks like.
I was really expecting the rest of HR to just ball in there and take that fight 3v3.
Yeah, it seems like the Clockwork thought that, too. SF going to be going for Ascati. Let him finish that up. He's already got, he actually buys the small items. And now just waiting on that ultimate orb.
Hex for Storm. Gives them quite a lot of pickup potential on Brewmaster and Phantom Lancer. So he forgoes the Orchid, goes straight into that late game disable.
You know, the heavy amount, like, I disagreed with it, but the heavy amount of Bloodstone charges that the Storm Spirit has worked out really well for him. More this game than any others. What I mean by that is that, like, the mana burn of the Phantom Lancer doesn't actually, like, completely cripple him. You know, because he's got so much mana regen, he's good. Dread, actually silence up Miracle Chipmunk. The initiation is good, but Iceberg still able to get off the ultimate. Miracle is going to go down. Johnny does manage to steal just something minor there, nothing good. And that looks like disaster there for Summoner's Rift, who now are just going to have to try and get out with the Brewmaster.
Yeah, that's not going to... Oh, he sends a storm up. They've got Hookshot.
They get the nuke.
They've got Hookshot.
The blink and...
Go on,
Gorak.
You've got it. You know where he is.
Oh, Brax hit himself in the trees. So close. Smart play by Brax, but Hellraisers... ultimately, I thought that was a little bit of mispositioning there from Dread at first, but because the Axe wasn't able to jump before the concussive shot and silence hit him, it just completely destroyed the initiation of Summoner's Rift. And because the SF is then able to get off his BKB ultimate uninterrupted by the Axe, the fight just falls apart for Summoner's Rift, and now that means Aegis for Hellraisers. Roshan
has fallen to the dark. Man, this is one of the reasons why Shadow Fiend is such a hot pick right now, and Brewmaster isn't. His ultimate did a lot in the early game, and got them kills, won them team fights, allowed them to turn things around when he was being initiated on, then swapped out, getting that split off, and... Oh no, PL! Hexed up, locked down.
And this is what happens. This is the downside of a Phantom Lancer, for sure. Holy cow, he's easy to pop real quick. Gorak, oh no, Brax lives just barely. Never mind. Artis says, how do you do, buddy? Trelf, he just needs another hit. Good. Turns around, gets off the rocket. And unfortunately, that means he gets out. Whew. So, at least Trial picks him off, TP's away, but Hellraisers are still looking good to be able to four-man down the middle lane if they want without the Brewmaster and the Phantom Lancer. See if they can force some buybacks, and if not, get a Tier 3 tower.
19 charges. Artez doing pretty damn well on the Storm Spirit, I've got to say. He did start off with a triple kill at 2.5 minutes in, though, and solving treads at like 3 or 4 minutes.
Yeah.
So it's not like he had a bad start and came back. He's just been steadily consistent.
Oh, yeah. Trouf? Trouf? Swap goes down. Artist is now going to be caught out. A little bit awkward. He does have an Aegis, though. Yeah, but he may still get out of here ahead of the Cooling Blade just in time. He is good. And now he's going to be sent back. Artist. Trying to go for that Cooling Blade. Doesn't quite get him. What happens if you die mid-sent back with the Aegis? I'm presuming it doesn't work, the sent back.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you come back to life where you die.
Yeah. Artist is going to be coming in with a long zip here pretty soon, but goddamn, is going to keep himself a little bit alive for a longer. Artist trying to go on a Banana Jam Slamma in the back. As Artist does manage to finish him off, still has that Aegis, is blocking up Miracle Chipmunk. He'll be able to take him down. Brewmaster just not doing anything here. Demon just barely ahead with that TP, while Brax is forced to just run away.
But you've got no buybacks now in your Phantom Lancer or Axe. This is going to be at least another lane of Axe, if not a game.
Yeah, potentially they just go into the tier 4s straight up. But they're going to start with tier 3 and bottom lane Axe first.
Oh.
Okay, Axe just ticked up gold somehow.
Fair enough. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, with the death thing, you know, sometimes you see the hero model fall down in the fountain as they died somewhere. Axe, what a great silence from Dread. Catching Miracle as he blinked in.
Absolute beautiful. Artist now is going to be... Again, they still can't take down. He still has the Aegis, and they are having troubles getting him once. And the thing is, like, every single time he escapes, you give him 5 seconds, and all of a sudden, he's got 800 extra mana from before. So, melee racks gonna fall, range racks soon to go down as well. And there it is, GG. So, they call it Summoner's Rift. Game one, pretty nasty, and this is on their home server, too. This one, US East. It's looking like Hellraisers might just 2-0 this.
When I was looking at the ping, in fact, let's just take a look again. Yeah, pretty much all of HR has between 250 and 300 ping. But to be fair, the Chen, I was really worried about his micro skills and being able to play on the US East server, but building Aghanims and Vlads means that you don't have to micro anything, you don't have to worry about anything.
Yep.
Someone says, I'm dying, you press R, you heal your entire team, you A-move creeps down.
Yeah, you really don't need to do that much.
He did not go onto lane with trolls or centaurs or anything at all.
Nope. Playing around your disadvantage. That's what that is. So, very well played by Hellraisers. We're going to take a break, guys. Game number two coming up after that.